Welcome back to the OPL. My name is Michael Hingers Hing, and we are about to see game two on week 9, day 1. Oh my goodness, I'm getting into my brain. Tainted Minds versus Avant Garde. I'm joined at the desk by Raz and Ejim. Guys, what do we reckon is going to be happening in this second game? Tainted Minds, we've seen they've been boot camping in Brisbane the last couple of weeks. How does that kind of affect play?
I think it's obviously just a big bonus all around. I think the biggest thing to take from boot camp or from like gaming house, like being together as a team as opposed to online, is the ability to like review properly. Like online, it's really hard to like navigate like people living in Melbourne, Sydney, Canberra, whatever.
Yeah.
And then like all trying to like watch the same VOD at the same time or whatever. Like it just doesn't work. So like being able to scrim all day, every day together, and then like at the night or whatever, you can like go through the VODs and like actually discuss things like with each other. It's really helpful.
And whenever like issues arise, you just pretty much hash them out as they are.
Yeah, immediately.
Exactly. Yeah. Rather than, all right, let me mute the team so you can get out of here.
Yeah, I'm going to go make coffee. Like,
all right, well, before the break, we were asking people for their dream teams on hashtag IAmOPL, and we got a few good ones to pull out so we can look at it. All right, the first one's on screen. This is from Keegan Payne. It's OPL dream team top Pac-Man. We got Jungle, Carbon, Mid, Swiffer, ADC is Raidair, and support T-Gun. Oh. Yeah, what do you guys think of that so far?
No Swifter, no clue.
Yeah. No Swifter.
But yeah, I'm a fan of that, you know. T-Gun support. The T-Gun Raidair bot lane, definitely liking that one.
All right, we also had another
They're pretty buff, T-Gun on Raidair.
They're both
pretty
that's
big.
True, that's true, that's true.
They just monster the opponents.
So we had also a tweet from LOL Hysterics, who's an OCS caster, and I put this together pretty quickly, actually. Top chippies, Jungle, Carbon, Mid, Looch, ADC, Lost, and support, Ejim, an aggressive team. How do you feel to be among... Would you want to play with those people, Ejim?
I would. Except for the fact that he misspelled my name. Come on, give me a capital G, man. Come on.
My God.
No, but that's a good team. That's a good team. Chippies, yeah. Carbon, Luke's just farming up a storm. Yeah.
All right, we'll go one last one. This is from Hans, Benringer 99. He's gone. Have a look at this, right? Okay. top, Carbon, Jungle, Juves, Mid, Carbon, ADC, Carbon, support, Carbon. How do you feel being replaced by Carbon in support?
I don't know, but I don't think I've actually ever seen him play support.
Yeah.
I've seen him play AD carry. It's not good, but like...
The best thing is that they legitimately just didn't give him the role that
he plays. Just get roasted by Jeeves.
Yeah, exactly. All right, well, let's take a look at these lineups for game two. Avant Garde, Paradise in the top lane, Chelby in the jungle, Triple in the mid lane, Chenny Boy, AD carry, and Jakey support. And we'll move on to the... This is Tainted Minds, Pradith in the top lane, Zaher in jungle, Omni in the mid lane, Lost, AD carry, and Rosie in support. Guys, what do you think of those lineups so far?
It's kind of funny because you literally get polar opposites in this sense. You get pretty much a strong top side from Avant Garde, and you get a strong bot side from Tainted Minds.
Mm.
Now, it's been pretty fun. I think that, like, the Zahi kind of plays towards bot side quite often.
Yeah, definitely.
Quite often.
Yeah.
You probably felt the wrath a little bit.
Bot camper.
While Chelby does help out Paradise quite a bit.
It's week 9, which means we're at the business end where we have to think about which teams are facing relegation, perhaps. What is at stake, Raz, for Tainted Minds and for Avant Garde in this match?
Well, Tainted Minds does have the matchup on Avant. They did take the game, the set against them. So if they win two games, if they win the rest of their sets, and if Avant Garde lose the rest of the sets, then they actually bump up.
Mm. We've also seen Tainted Minds' strength is in the bottom side, like you said.
Yep.
Do you see Avant Garde being able to compete with them there, Injim?
I think, as we stated, like the top side for AV is definitely their strong side. I think Lost and Rosie are just a much better duo. And also, they have the help of Zahi, who's like casual bot camper. Nice. But like, Rosie's been really liking the Leona recently. And then Chenny Boy is really liking the Jhin. And so I think, like, if AV are going to like blind pick something like a Jhin and then.
Or
TM,
an Ash too.
Yeah, just something immobile. Then Rosie's just going to pick Leona into it. And I think they're going to get pummeled in the bot lane.
I mean, you previously been a bit of a fan of Leona. And she's not really in the meta right now. Do you see her having a growing place?
I think she definitely has a place. I think she's very hard to blind pick, although Rosie just does what he wants. He just blind picks it, like they blind pick against us. I think it kind of gets punished by like the likes of Braum, because like Leona wants to go in, she engages on someone, and then Braum literally jumps and stands behind you.
Yeah.
Well, it stands in front of you, rather, and just blocks all the damage. So I think, yeah. It, like, she's okay. She has a place, but I don't think she's too strong.
Sure. Well, the conventional wisdom is that Avant are strong on the top side. How do you see Tainted Minds being able to compete with that, Raz?
Well, with lane per lane, that's how it is. But yeah. The issue that I see is that I think Avant is a much cleaner team. Surprisingly enough, the last time they played against Sin. And don't give me that face.
I don't know.
Just to get my point across, I think like the last time we saw that up against Sin, even though it was a 2-1, they actually just controlled. They had such a strong vision control. Controlled extremely early, had the towers taken down, used their waves properly, went to Baron, get wiped, unfortunately.
Get wiped?
They got wiped. But other than that, like, if I hope they fix that part of their play. But regardless of that, I thought they grew quite a bit.
I disagree. I think AV is kind of a team where, like, they're just like I guess it all bases around Paradise, who's just like this mega aggressive top laner. Yeah. Like, even if he gets ganked, he'll just go in for the kill. Like, he just fights literally everyone. Mm-hmm. And I think AV just kind of adopt that playstyle. And so AV just play this mega aggressive playstyle, and then it's really like bloodbathy, like there's a lot of kills all over the place. And I think if TM, or like if any team, not even specifically TM, if they're not ready to like match it, or they're not like ready to go in on that, then like you'll just get punished because they're super greedy and they get away with a lot.
All right, well, let's go straight to predictions then. Do you think this is going to be a closer series than the 2-0 we just saw?
Yep.
Yep. Who do you reckon is going to take it?
I think 2-1 AV.
Yeah, 2-1 AV.
I'd go 2-0 AV.
2-0 AV. All right, as we said before, these teams are all vying for places in finals. The OPL split two finals again August 13 up in Brisbane, or in Brisbane, I should say. Tickets are on sale right now. If you're not in Brisbane and you're around the country, you can see it in Hoyts cinemas around the country. You can go to the website that's on your screen right now. Well, shall we just throw to the casters and get into the game, shall we?
Let's get into it.
All right.
Let's do it.
Thank you very much, Ingers. And we are well and truly ready to get into this series, of course, of Hunt versus Tainted Mind. I had like a question planned out to throw to Rusty. It's gone now because that was brilliant.
Yep. Nice. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah, no, you don't. I didn't actually ask you anything. Do you think that Praedith is going to find his footing? Maybe we'll go to that one because Paradise has been a monster up towards the top side of the map. Tainted Minds put Praedith back in. They had Sazahu there who was actually getting some work done. Is that going to now be tested? Is Praedith now going to find a way in?
I have a pressing concern with Praedith and Sazahu as to why they're actually going to like make any kind of net difference. My thing is they were actually just the same person. And so I was never really too impressed with what Praedith has done so far. But I do think that Praedith is a young player with a lot of potential, and you would expect to see growth from him, especially since Tainted Minds have actually been boot camping together now in a house, being able to reflect on their VODs and improve at an increased rate.
Well, we'll see whether that's actually helped out Praedith. Of course, a very young player, only recently turned 17, was eligible to be in the OPL. So now you can see the bans are starting to come out. So Trundle and Azir both taken away. Trundle up against Praedith, doesn't want to get one of his strong champions as Bard taken away from Rosie, as it is every single time.
Yep, every time it's not, it usually causes a stir, as Tainted Minds tend to win those games.
They do.
So that anomaly has been taken off the board.
Well, you can see the top lane focus now coming in on the side of Tainted Minds. Paradise is Jack's not going to be seen. Aurelia still up. Definitely a big pick.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see whether the top lane is actually going to see a bit of a focus here as far as the picks are concerned as well. Whether AV want to take away one of those strong top lane champions or whether something is going to sneak through. I mean, Ryze, Vladimir, both of them still up as Omni's LeBlanc is going to be taken away. Of course, Rosie was telling us about the fact that, you know, LeBlanc, definitely Omni's favorite champion. New Caledonian himself does like the French lady in the mid lane.
Definitely does. So it's taken away from him. That's now three targeted bans that Avant-Garde have thrown at Tainted Minds. With the Vlad necessity, you would expect that
to
be
seen.
They
found the button. Oh, thank goodness. We can start this champion select off feeling good, Rusty. Paradise, we're looking at something like a Rek'Sai first pick here.
You would expect something along those lines, but given that Elise and Rek'Sai are both standing Gragas as well, there are three strong options, and it's not all in on the Rek'Sai unless they really don't want Zahi to have it, because it feels like in performance, Zahi does excel a little bit more when he's playing that Rek'Sai. With the Trundle gone, perhaps it's Braum that they look towards as a first pick option. Something that we have seen actually internationally rise up quite severely,
quite prominent. Karma is still another option as well, but I don't see Rosy being the type of player to go to the Karma because it just doesn't feel like he can get enough done.
I believe he's got Karma game, so like both of them would
have a
priority towards that, but we know that Rosy can play about 17 different support champions, and I think there's only 6 total.
Yeah, no, and I think, yeah, most of the champions that he likes to play in the support role are actually just completely different roles. We do love that about him, though. His Tainted Minds have their chance to pick up a couple of champions. The Karma was indeed locked away by Jake.
Yeah, with the Bard gone, with the Karma gone, perhaps it's the Braum now on the opposite side that we'll see, but we know he's got a Leona that he might prefer instead. There's a Zyra that he can still carry with. And I'm curious to see if they actually prioritize support in their first rotation or if they change it up.
Whoa! Okay, no they're not. As that's Cassiopeia and Aurelia. Aurelia locked away already. Omni wants to make sure the Snake Lady is well and truly in his pocket.
Uh-huh.
That's crazy.
That's an aggressive early draft here from Tainted Minds. They get Praedith on a carry, and they get Omni on a control mage in the middle lane. Makes sense to an extent, in that the players have gotten what they want to play.
Yeah.
But being on the red side of the map, they've just straight up said that we don't really care what our solo laners play or what they're matched against. All of our priority is on the bottom lane.
Well, possibly saving Lost Pick until last. We'll see what AV want to do. Of course, the Karma Sivir combination is definitely available to them. Can get a lot of movement speed around the map here for Avant.
Might even just go Jhin for the sake of having extra lockdown. The Ashe could be complemented by having the Karma as well.
Oh, actually, and Chenny Boy's Ashe is very strong, as well as his Jhin, which he has seen success in. His most recent performance was not necessarily what we wanted, but has since been able to claw that one back. But the Jhin Karma is going to be locked away, and Chelby, free Rek'Sai lock-in, just casually.
Yeah, and AV is a 3-man unit at the moment, have everything that they could possibly want as a team.
Yeah.
The Azir and Jax bans are definitely warranted when you think about who they're playing against. Of course, triple, a strong Azir, Paradise, a ridiculous Jax. But you still give over all of these incredible champions where Tainted Minds put a higher priority on the Aurelia and the Cassiopeia, knowing that this could be picked against them. We already said it, they could default to like the Elise in the jungle, the Gragas in the jungle. Same thing goes for support, there are plenty of champions, and Zahir's got all the same.
Yeah, and it just feels like Tainted Minds have shown their hand incredibly early. AV have just been able to casually go through their pick ban phase. It feels like the onus is on Tainted Minds here, already taking this sort of very aggressive stance as far as the draft is concerned. Lost, looking at his Lucian, has seen success. And Omni gonna grab the Gragas for Zahir. So Rosy, of course, the priority, going to be saved until last pick.
Well, supports can still dictate the pace of a lane, but they already knew who they were playing against as well, so very unusual that they still prioritize giving Rosy that last pick.
Yeah.
But because they'd locked in those solo lanes, as we mentioned, doesn't matter too much. The Tainted Minds, they've still set themselves up decently well. When you think about what they want as a team composition, this is pretty much it, barring perhaps LeBlanc instead of Cass. Of course, the bans force these things.
They certainly do. Now, AV looking for some solo laners themselves. Unless they want to put the Karma into the mid lane, could be something that could go up against a Cassiopeia, but I don't know how that matchup necessarily goes. Victor makes some sense, just answer the wave clear, but...
But I mean, like, a Victor in anything, like, just still works out nicely. I don't know what Paradise will go towards, because the Jax is gone, the Aurelia is gone, the Trundle's banned. But, like, it doesn't really matter what he picks at this point. Like,
yep.
That is so AV and meta.
Severely, as the Fiora is actually the switch up there for Paradise. Bit of a shout out to Praedith, who definitely played a heck of a lot of the champion. Paradise himself, I mean, get him on a carry, and he's going to do exactly that.
Mm-hmm.
Rosy, does he now go to the Leona?
Well, he knows that there's a Fiora that can kill his AD carry, so he might default to something like the Janna to keep him alive. Braum, I said it a couple of times, still makes the most sense to me given that he is against the Jhin. So I feel like they should definitely just lock Braum in and call it a day, given that Bard's gone.
This is something I wanted to talk to you about, though, because Rosy just, he shies away from the Braum. He's not necessarily a guy that really wants to play the big man with a door.
Yeah, I don't enjoy playing the best support champion either.
Come on, Bard's the best support champion.
Bard's bad. Yeah. We're going with the next best thing.
Yeah, okay, good point, good point.
No, I think that, like, even in this particular matchup, I think, like, Braum actually makes the most sense, unless you really want to go, like, full defensive. I think Rosie's supplement champion's usually Leona, as it is.
He has played at least one Braum game so far, and the Leona is what he's going to pick up. So there it is.
Yep.
It's just rosy things here. Wants to chuck the sunlight onto the opponents, try and get the work done. Of course, if there's ever a champion that can actually proc that sunlight very effectively, it is going to be the Lucian, which is good. Lane combo works, but of course, Braum Lucian has been something that we've been speaking about for I don't know how many splits now, and would still be extraordinarily strong. So we'll see whether Rosie can prove himself now on his unorthodox Leona pick. I'm glad that we spoke about it on the desk as well to set up for what could be Tainted Minds really letting us know exactly what the power of this Leona is going to be. Because Triple, I guess he does have the cleanse, but there's a lot of hard CT now to really take advantage of the fact that he will have to flash to avoid anything like this.
Yeah, and for what it's worth, the difference between the Braum and the Leona here is that they've got more hard engage on Tainted Mind's side. Jin yep. stands still. Triple may have that cleanse you mentioned, but they can still get onto him. There's still a lot of other tools that aren't just the Gragas going in now that can set Tainted Minds up. And if Rosie's a big voice in the team, it might make life a lot easier for them.
Yeah, it's a very good point. And of course, it does look like Tainted Minds have just picked exactly what they want in every single role. So we'll see where the comfort is going to be able to come out ahead for them. But if you believe the other side of the rift does have the power as Avant, use that hashtag AVWin on Twitter, or think that Tainted Mind's comfort will be able to get them over the line, use that hashtag TMWin and let us know whether you think that the boot camp is going to have paid off. Because of course they had some really sweet laptops out of it. Like, man, things must be feeling good because they're all playing together.
Yeah, that's the first big question we have to ask of Tainted Minds. Has the boot camp helped Avant? They need to win this one to secure yep. themselves a semi-finals berth, so very important for this team also to move into our first game.
Yeah, so on to Summoner's Rift now, and we'll see whether Avant can actually carry it through. Very casual in their draft phase, saved their solo laners, everything pretty easy days. Shelby back on the Rek'Sai as well. This is a guy that's been known to be able to farm everything out, make incredibly aggressive plays, invade everywhere, do all of the things. Be very, very comfortable doing it. But Zahi on the Gragas, and we've seen Gragas be very successful so far, especially today, as Carbon got back-to-back wins on the guy.
Shelby's definitely a sporadic player. Never really know what he's going to do next, and that's the beauty of him in the jungle. But sometimes he's invading, sometimes he's just farming his own jungle. Occasionally he's ganking. You can never really predict it. So it takes a good jungler to contest with him. But because Triple is his dynamic duo in that middle lane, they can just kick it together and cause a lot of problems, exploiting what has been defined as the weaker points of Tainted Minds. They win through their bottom lane duo. Zahi predictably spends a lot of time in the bottom lane. And so the question's always going to be there. Can they change it up? Can they play to a different strategy and try and maybe take Avant by surprise? Or just show that they have something new?
Well, it does look like the lane swap's been read here by Tainted Minds. Is Rosie going to wander over a ward but head towards this Grom camp as the upside down lanes look to ensue? Zahi does get the slowdown there as Chenny Boy with a fair bit of damage. See what he's actually taken. The Dancing Grenade is often the option. There's both of them now following through. Rosie looking for a possible turnaround. Misses the Q on the side of Jake. They will make it towards this lane. Now Rosie looking for it. Does manage to get in there as there's the double exhaust coming out. Heals flying through as well as everyone's just battling. Chenny having to reload now as well is very dangerous. As you can see, Jake at full health. Very comfortable as Dancing Grenade actually happily picking up some minions here at the same time. And so far, this duo is explosive.
Yeah, definitely is. Lost still has his heal and flash, as does Rosie, so it comes down to that level 2 spike. As now these two are just going at it as well.
Oh, this poison is really going to tick down. It's Omni getting the Twin Fangs in, Triple having to flash, and my god, that's why they picked this so early.
Well, Cassiopeia has always got that level 2 strength available to it. My attention is still definitely near that Leona lane hitting that level 2 point. It'll be very interesting to see how this pans out, but so far so good for Tainted Minds at an individual level. Nothing more, nothing less.
Yeah, definitely a summoner spell advantage here as well, as, like you said, Lost holding onto that heal. Chenny Boy without his. Now the Mantra Q launches itself towards the backline, and Shelby looking for a very early gank here onto Omni. Does still, of course, have the flash, but there's the flash knock-up. Omni gets himself out, but uses both the Ghost and the flash in order to escape.
Yeah, the two-for-one special there, essentially, from Shelby, meaning he can come back around whenever he would please. Zahi quite low, doing what seems like a full clear. In fact, he's just incredibly low for no particular reason as a Gragas.
Smites the red buff, gets himself a bit of health back, but you're right.
Not a whole lot of health, that's for certain.
Mm-hmm.
Again, he's not able to have an impact on the map. Shelby is. That's the difference.
Already blowing double summoner spells as well, and positions himself on the top side of the map, so Tainted Minds do have to actually pay some respect here to the jungler's positioning, as Rosie standing on a ward, Definitely well positioned here for Avant.
Has the bush, but doesn't have control because AV can see him, as you said. But it means that he's always got the opportunity to go forward as he's looking, and Zahi's here. Not exactly a stock standard ganking maneuver.
No. This Jenny boy, he wants to get that dancing grenade so badly. Feel it. There it is. Nice damage onto Lost there as well, with the last hit adding some extra damage. They're looking to try and hold onto this lane, put it into a position that they want it to be in. Shelby, without the flash, going back to base now as well, will grab his tracker's knife. Pink ward there as well. Begin his onslaught of the jungle one more time. AV defusing this bottom lane pressure actually quite nicely.
Yeah, holding their own given the summoner spell deficit.
Wow, good turnaround there from Rosie to avoid the stun.
But still so much damage that comes out of Chenny. It's a uniquely powerful lane that we're seeing from AV in the 2v2. One of the perks of this is when Chenny has a guaranteed crit, Jiki can just speed him up with the shield.
Yeah, can get himself in there.
And hit the crit 100% of the time almost. Plenty of disengage available and damage from Jiki to follow it up. So the 2v2 strength is there. And the fact that they're keeping up with Rosie and Lost spells a lot of positives as we move further into the game.
Have you ever looked at Chelby and thought of him as a territorial jungler? He feels incredibly territorial to me.
Not always. I mean, sort of.
Because, like, that battle for the Rift Scuttler was like, no, this is my Rift Scuttler. I'm sorry. I don't know, just a thought. Just
a little bit. Like, I think there's more than one shade of Chelby. Sometimes he is territorial and says that this land is his land and he will fight for it, very akin to that of Carbon in the jungle position. Mm-hmm. But occasionally he does different things. Jarvan game is an example from a couple of years ago.
That's a very good point.
Just decides he wants to kill everybody instead.
He does do exactly that. Zahi getting some vision here on the other side of the map, however. Getting himself towards the top side. And look, Ejim did mention it. There's a bit of a tent.
Towards
erected.
The top side, meaning towards the 2v2.
Yes.
Is what we are saying. And for some reason, yeah, we've continued this lane swap and he still feels the propensity to be near this area.
First dragon, of course, is going to be that Cloud Drake, so not exactly high priority as Chenny Boy in a good position now with this mini wave as Praetor. Trying to get aggressive onto Paradise, but there's the weak spot. Paradise still looking for more, has the lunge, gets the weak spot, gets the movement speed. And we'll see what is going to be more important, the Grand Challenge or, of course, the Transcendent Blades. Paradise seems to think that he's the one with the power.
He just has a better vital proc, as there you go. The second the vital ends, Praetor feels a little bit more confident. These two still within touching distance of one another and kill range, but Praetor has more sustain. So should win out on that one sooner or later, as Zahi's actually made his way down.
Oh, Praetor's actually... Sorry, Paradise going the wrong direction. Really nice use of the riposte as he dashes his way out, so survives, but uses the summoner spell.
Zahi actually mistiming his body slam there. Not able to get the stun. The body slam into a riposte. Unfortunate, as now Chelby on the opposite side of the rift. He is about to get damaged.
Yeah, there's the Shield of Daybreak as well. Lots of damage comes out of Lost, getting lots of resets with that passive, but he's going to be okay. Chelby escapes. He'll have to go back.
Yeah, pushes him out. Of course, not level 6 means that Chelby's not going to be available in the next couple of seconds and gives an opportunity for Zahi to be aggressive, as you were seeing, on the opposite side of the rift, taking away the red buff.
Yeah, doesn't have the level 6 either, Chelby, so can't get over towards that red buff. Zahi will be able to lock this one down. Nicely played by Tainted Minds, reacting to where AV are positioned.
And not only that, Praetor already having pushed out the lane with Zahi and won the 2v2 trade. Means that they felt a little bit more confident on that side, as it were. And for an 8-minute game so far, these teams have been pretty much even.
Yeah, it feels like a good turn on a dime at this stage. You can see the top lane matchup. Praetor's going to make his way back now with the Sheen. There's a Phage in the hands of Paradise, but is that Sheen going to turn things around? Because I have a feeling that these short trades for Aurelia might be helping out.
Yeah, you want to trade in burst, but it all actually mostly just comes down to if you can hit the stun or if it can get riposted. It's always going to be a skill matchup. The Sheen will help. But so does all of the AD that the Fiora picked up anyway, proccing vitals.
Yeah, true.
And so it's always entirely skill-based.
Right now, Praetor's just going to try and grab all of the CS that he can as it heads towards his turret. 10 CS behind as he's leaping his way around.
Yeah, most of that CS was in the wave that was already amassed down there anyway. There's still the attention needs to be towards this 2v2 for Tainted Minds and more towards the 1v1 between Paradise and Praetor for Avant. Delicate balance that is yet to tip.
Really nice reaction time there from Chenny Boy. Make sure he gets the captive audience damage. Not going to find it under Rosie there as there's the Zenith play. Jake taking so much damage. Nice exhaust is lost. Might get tethered, but doesn't. There's the curtain call. Rosie takes two of the bullets. One more to be blocked there from Lost as there's the... Oh my gosh. The ultimate comes out from Zahi for the disengage, but Tainted Mind's very lucky to be alive at this point.
They use their health bars as their only resource of choice, though. No summoner spells burnt. So for what it's worth, that's actually a good outcome. TM Chelby was nearby. There was a lot of threat potentially available. But again, nice work from Chenny. He's shown that he's an entirely capable Jhin player. Has been doing work with this champion lately.
Yeah, and it seems like as soon as he's in a position where he can pick a utility champion and be able to get through a laning phase. I mean, he's not playing aggressively necessarily. These are all reactive plays that AV are making. But it seems to be his complete wheelhouse on the side of Chenny Boy, which is interesting when you think about his lineage as being a Vayne player.
His lineage is more so being an Orianna player, which is why that's actually still
a very
make
good point.
Sense.
Okay.
It looks like they don't actually want the Drake. They're using the Drake as a... something that just wants to do a lot of damage. Thank you, Cinderhawk.
Yeah.
You got Chenny.
Yeah, he doesn't have very much mana here either, as there's the Solar Flare. This is what level 6 means for this matchup. Lost outside of turret range, so he's going to be completely fine. And there it is. Rosie hits level 6, and they say go.
You can't tell me that wasn't disrespect, though, from Chenny Boy that comes back to bite him. Look at the wards they have in the lane. There's only one spot Rosie can be, like 100% knowledgeable through vision that they have. And he still dies to it.
Didn't use his heal either.
Completely misplays.
Well, now going to respawn, going towards his Ghost Blade, of course. They lost same items for the moment, but that's with an extra back in him. We'll be very close to that. We saw King, what you can do with a Lucian who gets this early advantage. That's pretty gross.
Yeah, Lost, of course, still one of the better AD carries in the league.
Oh, yeah.
He's got Rosie to back him up with all of the stuns. Still four summoners stand. For Tainted Minds, knowing there's no exhaust available for Jakey and no flash for Chenny, they could still potentially 2v2.
Zahi's actually looking for it. Gets the flash body slam. Chenny Boy delivered to Rosie. Shield of Daybreak's there, and Zahi picks it up with a bit of a bop. And they take themselves the turret. Tainted Minds, this boot camp looks to have done some work for the team.
Very cute decision making from Tainted Minds, and that cute play works out nicely for them. The gold lead started to accelerate through their 2v2. We're yet to see any transition on the opposite side of the map for AV where they look like they're in control. And at this stage, they're just giving opportunity after opportunity for Lost to grow stronger.
You can see in the mid lane, Omni doing absolutely fine here in this matchup. Just stacking that tier over and over again. Actually doesn't have any ability power apart from that Doran's Ring in his build so far. So just getting himself to a point where he's happy, but in control of this lane quite a lot against Triple. As I say, that gets death raid.
He wants to recall though. He'll have a fair bit of money, I would imagine, to spend with 130 CS and only the tier and a null magic mantle. It might just be this straight up Abyssal Scepter, or he could just go Morelos.
Yeah.
That was a full Morelos.
Oh god.
Like full. He had over 3,000 gold.
Okay.
It's things like this that like surprise me that you can get away with it. You can sit middle lane for 3,000 gold worth of time against a Rek'Sai when you know the Gragas is just going to focus the bottom lane. Small things like that. Like, that means he is actually extremely weak if you get on top of him. And there was summoners burned earlier. He didn't come back, Chelby.
No, he didn't. Body Slam's going to miss, though, as Chelby sidesteps it. Rosie comes over, doesn't throw a Zenith Blade in. Jake's going to back up his jungler. AV need to wrestle some control back in this game, though. That Cloudrake still standing. Zahi doing some work. The Gragas actually out farming the Rek'Sai here at this point.
Now, Chelby spending a lot of time addressing vision. Not so much getting ganks off. Not always in the right place at the right time either. There's now Tainted Mines. They get that top lane turret. They don't need to stay up there. In fact, they may as well come down and have a look at the Drake. If it's a free objective for them to take.
And that was an organic turret take there as well, just capitalizing on the kill under Jenny Boy. So, meaning now that they can just once again have pressure on this outer turret freely, because Paradise is huge. Look at this guy. He's got a black cleaver already.
Give him the culling.
Oh my god.
Yeah, that guy's big.
Yeah, so they don't really want to be going up against him. I feel like the 1v2 might actually be in favor of the old Fiora.
Yeah, so, like, the thing is, he's going to stay strong until the Trinity Force is even picked up in response, and they haven't gotten Praedith going. So it's a little bit of a mismatch in that respect, as Zahi's now actually here this time.
Yeah, Grand Challenge does come in as Equilibrium Strike. No stun to be had. You can see Chelby actually launches his way over the top as well. There's the riposte. Transcendent Blades comes through. Chelby just playing defense.
Paradise wins a 1v2. Very well done once again from this Fiora. Has the teleport if he chooses to go back to base. But he's confident enough with Chelby nearby that the 1v1 is still reasonably close to his. You have to be careful of an Aurelia sustain with the W and auto attacks though.
Oh god, Praedith gets riposted and that's going to be it. Paradise just making this Fiora look easy on the top side.
And this speaks volumes to Paradise's strength. We already called this a skill matchup and he's already proven now that he has the skills to 1v1 and 1v2 successfully. Zahi came to the top lane to help out, but by the time that he actually got here, it was at a point where it felt like it was too late already. Paradise had the item spike, and only now should Zahi have made the effort to come in, given the Trinity Force spike.
Well, the teleport is going to come in, as there's the explosive cast, but Chelby just burrows his way out, gets a bit of help from that cask, and Zahi looking a bit out of sorts.
Yeah.
Not able to lock that one down.
It's extremely out of sorts, and again, the mechanics were disrespectful there from the Gragas. Instead of just throwing the ultimate, he also misses the body slam. That's not ideal for the Gragas, not ideal for Tainted Minds. But we already spoke about top and bottom side strengths. It feels like that's very much coming to fruition here.
Oh yeah.
And they're going to meet in the middle. And that's where the difference will actually lie, if Triple can start popping off or if Omni can hold it down.
Well, Omni, of course, with that massive 3,000 gold purchase. Still actually staying even in farm here with Triple, not claiming too much more, as Triple has actually been able to play fairly well away from this Cassiopeia.
Not going to lie, I'm pretty sure that Triple will have a fair chunk of gold himself at this point as well.
Well, he's got two upgrades in his hex core and a needlessly large rod. I mean, that's a fair bit of money in his back pocket as well that he's already spent.
And then choosing to go for the needlessly large rod opposed to upgrading the perfect hex core.
Yeah, true.
Different decision from him. Doesn't necessarily mean too much. That's just his choice.
Of course, with the perfect hex score, you get extra movement speed for your Chaos Storm, as well as the, I guess, vortex ability of your gravity field.
The W becomes a mini Orianna ultimate.
Yeah.
Delayed the objective.
Cute from Triple. Tries to get it with the Death Ray, but Tainted Minds locked down the Cloud Drake. Didn't see what dragon's coming next, because I am oblivious.
I believe the icon on the top left of your screen will indicate that. If it doesn't change, it'll stay as a cloud.
Chelby looking for a dive onto Omni here. Petrifying Gaze finds nothing. A little bit of a misclick maybe as Chelby flashes out of the way. Teleport comes in. And AV brute forcing this outer turret in the mid lane. Teleport cancelled. They aren't able to grab that one, but that was odd.
They actually could have finished that teleport. Paradise not feeling confident. I think he should have felt more confident. There was nothing to actually kill him. There's no Gragas ulti, no Cassiopeia ulti. They will still have enough tools to pressure this, and it feels like his decision was more so to just continue winning the top lane instead of helping them out.
Well, able to move over the top here. Really good solar flare on the bottom side of the map, though, as Rosie locks them down. Nice shield comes out from Jake onto Chenny, but Lost is under the turret. Throws down the heal, gets the movement speed, but the Zenith Blade just too short, and Jake survives. Still, Tainted Minds claiming a lot of power down here.
Only the smallest of margins actually keep Jakey alive. Chenny does fall, and this strength that they now have in a 2v2 is starting to become a real issue for AV.
The question is, what's more important? Having a super strong top side of the map or a super strong bottom side of the map? Because this is exactly what's happening. It's what we predicted towards the beginning. And how will it work as this game moves forward? Gigantic Fiora versus gigantic Lucian.
The meta favors the Fiora, but there's also a Cassiopeia to potentially contend with him. Gragas also has a bit of disengage. And what's stronger isn't really a factor. It's more so how do these team compositions complement one another in that respect. And having that Leona there, it's going to be difficult to lock down a Fiora with a Leona, plain and simple. Riposte can cause a lot of problems.
Yeah, it's almost like that first bit of CC needs to land. And then you can layer it really effectively, but otherwise it can be hard.
Yeah, exactly. One stun hits, you'll probably get a lot of it, and time for Lost to hit the Fiora. And Fragile Champions will be going head-to-head. Except that the problem will remain, and this is where it might favor AV. Paradise can split push. He can win a 1v1.
Also, I guess, the kill advantage that Lost does have much higher than that of Paradise. He's got 50 CS in the lead. Praedith now playing very far back, just trying to keep himself alive. Everything's going to be okay. However, it is 3-1 in the kills. 2-0-1 for Lost on this Lucian. Trying to get that snowball happening, and he's taking down the turrets.
Yeah, definitely right. Once this bottom lane turret falls for Tainted Minds, they could accelerate. They don't really have somewhere to put Cassiopeia, though. And it's actually really important they set up for vision and objectives well. Otherwise, they just run into risks of sharing farm, sitting in lanes together, places you don't necessarily want to be. As that turret's gone.
Yeah, there's the Grand Challenge one more time on Dazahi. The riposte comes in, but there's a decent body slam. Really good barrel comes out as well, but Paradise is still alive. Good double knock up there from Chelby to make sure that he stays that way as well, as the tunnel is going to need to be used, but the body slam comes in. The Equilibrium Strike slows him down, and Praedith grabs it with the Blade Surge.
Has Flash.
Yeah, gets a reset. Actually wants to find more here as Triple's making his way up, but decides against it.
There's a minion wave, though.
Ooh, scary times. And Tainted Minds getting some more power here towards the top side and extending their gold lead.
Yeah, not too bad once again from Tainted Minds. The turret did fall, so Paradise achieved his purpose, and Chelby becomes a sacrificial void monster.
Guy,
not a lady. And ends up going down for it. AV still have win conditions, but Tainted Minds are creeping ever so slightly ahead, piece by piece. The jigsaw puzzle's coming together.
Certainly as Tiamat was done there from Paradise as well. Now trying to build up with some tanky stats. Has the cloth armor, as well as, oh, Solar Flare isn't going to find triple for the stun, but does get the slow, as Lost going to be slowed down as well. Mantrid Q comes in. Big cooldown there from Tainted Minds, but Solar Flare, not too high. He'll be able to reset that one and come back.
I feel like it was used to try and zone triple away from wave clearing, but he already got the laser down.
Ah.
So the minions were actually taken away. Not too sold on the strategy once again, but the Leona has a low cooldown on the ulti. Not too far away from already being halfway back to available again. And this is the last remaining thing for Tainted Minds to do, break this middle lane.
Well, Jenny Boy's actually going to get delivered to Lost here on the bottom side of the map as well. Zahi, if anything, he's getting himself around the map. His positioning has been fantastic in order to capitalize on AV.
Yeah, decision-making's been great from Zahi. It was just those mechanics that were lacking at the start. Still having a lot of positive moments here.
Yeah.
Now it feels like they're actually threatening the bottom lane inner turret instead of grouping elsewhere. Cassiopeia is duking it out 1v2 throughout this. And once again, the strategies continue.
Oh, only two minions here in order to get some chip damage down, but with three members here, they'll get at least about two-thirds. Rosie tanks the turret shot, but isn't too worried.
They want to fight this.
And Triple's going to make his way in. Chelby takes a fair bit of damage first. Miasma over the top, but of course the Cassiopeia not in position. Teleport comes down. Praedith gets himself amongst the fight. Equilibrium Strike on Paradise doesn't get the stun. As Praedith going to get stunned up. Curtain Call comes in. There's the Grand Challenge as Paradise tries to get the work done, but Praedith's out of position and unable to be killed by AV. Lost throws down the Culling, finds a minion wave as well as the back of some AV heads, but otherwise has to be disengaged.
Yeah, they go towards the Cloudrake. It feels like Tainted Minds have momentum towards this. They have a lot of damage to it as well, but AV are not shying away from control of the map. Does not mean they will actually go for the Drake. It actually means they're looking more towards the middle lane. Interesting balance now being tipped towards AV, perhaps.
Trying to get that inside track. Gravity Field goes down. There's the Flash Body Slam. They're looking for Paradise, but he survives for the moment. Chaos Storm does so much damage. Azahi's already dead. Rosie in the backline. Shelby's going to burn to death as Omni gets it with the poison. And Lost still looking for more. My god, he does so much. As Jake just gets destroyed, but he's going to survive. Here's a one-for-one. Jungler's dead.
Yeah, this is still a big Lucian that they need to contend with. So much burst actually comes out.
Omni?
He's flirting with danger. But he's got Rosie to back him up. And again, it's the Lucian. The summoner spells are still there. The strength is still there from him. But Triple turns things around with a lot of burst of his own. And effectively just becomes a one-for-one with junglers.
Yeah. Chenny Boy also looks to be building towards either a Black Cleaver or a Trinity Force. New Trinity Force actually feels like a really cool idea, as Praedith is in a whole host of trouble. Grand Challenge comes in, gets the slow from the riposte. They're not going to bite off more than he can chew.
Uses his riposte a lot early in these engages. So Praedith can kind of just play him for the fool and walk away. But he's still so far ahead. Look at the farm difference between top laners.
Yep.
Yes, that is contrasted to AD carries, but this is always going to be a concern in the 1v1 strength that a Fiora has. The closer he creeps to that level 16 point, the less of a cooldown his ultimate will have. And that means more often than not, he will just beat the Aurelia.
He just went back and got a Dead Man's Plate there as well. So Tiamat, Black Cleaver, Dead Man's Plate, he's set up.
I mean, full defensive as well on the flip side from Praedith, recognizing that. So smart itemization from the Aurelia.
Yep.
To not continue dying or losing lane. He's not really dying. But he just doesn't need to die. The goal is to let Tainted Minds win elsewhere on the map. Xana probably could have altered that instead.
And actually, it looks like Chenny Boy is going towards the Black Cleaver.
Yeah.
I actually really like it because he's now realized that he's so far behind. He's 0-4-0. Has to be utility. 40% CDR, as well as the fact that he can amplify the damage that Paradise and Shelby are going to be doing in these fights. That Curtain Call can get a lot of those Black Cleaver stacks down.
I guess what they really need now is like a Titanic Hydra from Shelby, I suppose, but they still need a frontline tank, so he can't really afford to do that. The Black Cleaver decision is not bad.
I like the theory behind it. Don't know whether it's good.
Yeah, it's not like a snowbally Duskblade. It's not a defensive Maw of Malmortius, which still gives you armor penetration. It's more saying that everyone's building armor, so it's not efficient for me to get 10 extra armor penetration as a flat amount. It means that his damage to tanks will be higher, but to carries will be less, and that's an interesting decision.
Especially when Lost needs to be dealt with, but Paradise probably saying, oh, no, I got that. I'll just lunge me way into the back line. Rip them apart. Four men strong here, though. Tainted Minds move into the mid lane as Chaos Storm probably needs to move to the minion wave. Come on, there it is. Triple gets back over. Clears it out.
Pushing him away with that. But it's a decently high cooldown in comparison to what Tainted Minds use simply by having bodies present. There's a Cassiopeia bottom lane right now about to find Paradise.
Well, Randuin's gets the slowdown as Paradise looking for more Miasma comes in, but Paradise is going to be okay. Lunges out of the way, flashes the wall, and Triple's going to come over in time. Omni still chasing this one through as Triple gets a gravity field. Deathray comes in, Rylai's there for the slow. Paradise survives.
Yeah, makes a mistake there a little bit, Omni. You need to have that grounded available so they can't flash or queue away. The damage wasn't able to follow it up because he unfortunately missed it. Expected a juke downwards. So they don't get what they came for. They do push the Fiora away, though.
Chenny Boy, now to help out with this wave clear in the mid lane. Triple says, don't need none of that. Pretty good. 300 CS at 27 minutes. Same as Omni, actually, 305. Both of these mid laners just having the best time ever. And Jake going to play us some sweet music as he goes back home.
Yeah, mid laners usually feel their best when they're farming minions.
Oh, yeah.
Like the natural habitat. So that's all they really want to do. They drafted themselves to do that, for what it's worth. So again, strong top side, strong bottom side from opposite teams, but an equal mid lane. That could be like the actual knife's edge that tips in a direction.
Yeah.
Because Drakes don't really mean a lot. There's going to be a third cloud again. We're really getting RNGesus today.
Mm-hmm. But Tainted Minds now have two, and if you think about it, Cassiopeia, can't buy boots.
We've had this conversation every time.
I know, I just want it to be good, man.
But do you know how much like time you save with three Cloud Drakes walking from the bottom lane to the middle lane through river?
How much?
About 2 seconds, maybe. That's probably less.
That's not very much.
No.
Damn it. All right, well, that's a bit sad.
Yeah. Then again, percentage move speed bonuses from a Phantom Dancer and stuff.
Yeah, impact more. That
might
true.
Make it up to 3 seconds. That starts to add up.
I think we're close.
But you know what would have been nice? 24% AP. Or a lot more damage to neutral monsters and towers.
Yeah.
Or despicable regen. Literally every other Drake.
Yeah, okay, good point. But they do have 2 Cloud Drakes, guys.
They do.
So, good for them. Look, they get that cool animation, which is really fun. Makes you feel fast, even if you're not necessarily going that much faster.
It's pretty badass with a Dead Man's Plate and the blue.
Oh, yeah.
Buffers. Lost is actually
caught. Oh, my God, just dead. Shutdown comes in for Chenny Boy as the curtain call comes in. It's exactly that. And it's lights out for the super fed Lucian. Chenny Boy, that would have felt satisfying. It's now AV's turn to pick up some relatively irrelevant movement speed.
Yeah, well, hits him on the dash, actually. So Lost going down with Summoners up. Forced, once again, by triple hitting the laser on him. Slows him down, makes him need to dodge the second aspects of it. And strong movements from AV in their team composition. Jin has that unique strength, much like Ash does. 2 of the only AD carries where you can walk mid and probably kill the person mid.
Yeah, well, he did exactly that. Still incredibly far behind in farm. That's approximately 70 CS that he's down.
Also sculpting themselves towards the late game AV by having the cleanse on their middle laner. Against the Cassiopeia, and it's not ideal to have that against what is high kill threat. We even saw triple flash at level 2 to the damage that Omni had. There was no real trading back available. But because he wants to avoid Rosie's stuns, which is the engage tool, and he needs that cleanse to survive team fights, so AV, they're getting themselves towards a point where they can fight quite successfully. As we are actually 30 minutes in. The gold lead is less than 1,000.
Yeah, this is nothing.
Nobody's pulling the trigger on anything besides Drake's.
And it just seems like AV were happy to weather that bottom lane storm, utilize the fact that Fiora is so huge. She will be able to win in this split push scenario, currently 70 CS ahead in her own right. Omni having this extra power, looking good as Bears. Oh my goodness, all of the damage once again. It's a Chaos Storm. He's going to be able to lock down the kill onto Rosie. Curtain Call doesn't find Omni. Last bullet sails by casually.
Okay, I actually have a big gripe with what Rosie just did.
What did he just
do? I'm not going to go on a rant about it. I'm just going to tell you that he made a big mistake by spending 15 seconds looking at the ward he wanted to kill, opposed to either killing it or not being in vision of it.
Yeah.
That actually set Tainted Minds up for a really bad situation where AV just killed him. Triple does a lot of damage at the moment. Chenny's still hovering around that middle lane to capitalize on it. As twice now, the Tainted Minds have been picked out by that combo. And if it continues to happen, it's going to ultimately dispel the undoing of the red side of the rift.
In goes Chelby. AV's bottom lane now just hanging out here towards the top side of the map. There is a pink ward there in the brush. Lost is going to spot it. Zahi there as well. Praedith looking to try and defend as the Fiora getting over there. And AV actually want to fight here. Chelby, lots of movement speed with that Dead Man's Plate as well as his upgraded boots.
Yeah, 2 Dead Man's Plates running around on their top laner and jungler. They can close distances pretty effectively. That's kind of Victor every time the Q connects. And a Karma to speed them all up.
Yeah.
They have a lot of gap closing through just movement speed. And Paradise has so much control of this lane.
Well, Ravenous Hydra there as well, so infinite sustain. Hidden Spell not really meaning too much here as the Baron's gonna get mad at Chelby. Jumps over the top, there's Omni and Rosie waiting around here, and Chelby says, oh, nah, maybe not. Not gonna battle this one, look at all these captive audiences.
He actually valued the Baron's damage more than a Leona and a Cassiopeia. Or whoever was on the other side of that wall. Like, that's a ballsy move from Shelby. He's also croaking quite loudly at the moment. He just keeps making the noise.
Well, there's a flash body slam actually. Azahi's going to get immediately knocked up. Didn't connect with the target that he wanted as Triple's able to cleanse flash out. Gets himself the kill with the Chaos Storm as Omni's going to get that damage transferred to him. Knock up comes in. Solar Flare flash. As Lost gets himself out, as now Paradise looking to try and close in. The weaknesses are now exposed, but they do manage to disengage. Zahi's dead, Omni has to go back, and AV look at Baron.
And exposed is the key word. The AV team composition is entirely just exposing what Tainted Minds want to do. on the back of those picks onto just one member. It still forces recalls. Rosie has no health and he's hanging around. They cannot contest the Baron.
Yeah, Zahi's dead. 10 seconds, he's not going to make his way back in here, so the big purple worm is going to die. Chelby able to lock that one down. Now everyone in powered recalls back home. Now time to get the siege on. Tainted Minds against the flow, able to take down this outer turret in the mid lane, but it's probably the end of the good news stories here for this Tainted Minds squad.
Yeah, 100% of the stories that are good are now gone. This has been 5 to 10 minutes of Tainted Minds having a lead and doing nothing with that lead to the point where AV have been able to catch up into this game and now put themselves ahead. The hyphy moves from Zahi. Don't get any kills. In fact, he dies for it. And look at the undoing now of Tainted Minds hitting mid-game. Not having a strategy, not having a win condition, not playing towards it.
Well, Solar Flare in a slow triple down, but that's about all it's going to do. The Siege minion still in amongst it, getting the work done as Omni's going to get caught out. Knock-up comes in as well as there's the Petrifying Gaze, gets Jakey in triple. But is it enough as the Curtain Call's there doing a whole host of work and Omni's going to fall? This inner turret's going to follow there as well as Paradise is getting the work done on the top side of the map. Chelby moves through the wrong side. Interesting. Takes a lot of damage from Lost. Decides to do it again because he feels like it.
Yeah, and this Jhin went 0-4 in lane, is now 2-4 and has been making picks. Paradise is winning the 1v1, which is where AV were hovering towards. And instead, they don't have to go up there. They can just take those turrets. The presence they have as a four-man unit with 20 seconds on Omni is starting to become a little bit overbearing.
Now as well, Chelby actually helping out his top laner as there's the grand challenge. Praedith has a big shield on himself as Zahi comes in with a body slam and Paradise flashes himself out. Lost has been exhausted as Paradise was delivered to him, but is going to be able to pick up the kill. You can see now AV with all of the shields trying to disengage. They know all of their power has been destroyed as Paradise not going to be able to find too much more, but that was close.
Yeah, if Paradise actually took out Praedith, things could have been entirely different. Steric's gauge is enough to keep him alive. So the Aurelia lives to see another day. Even goes to teleport in to try and capitalize on a turnaround. This is an Elder. And it's available. Painted yeah. Minds might have Chelby.
Don't get him just there. Walks off the Miasma.
This is really aggressive. 20 seconds on Paradise, who does not even have his teleport. Means that it will be 4v5. But they are missing a fair bit of health and mana across them, and they're tanking the Elder.
And there's the Curtain Call coming in as well as Praedith takes a lot of damage. Rosie takes the last one. Big crit to the face of Zahi as well. You can see very, very low. AV want none of this, but they're just more than happy for Tainted Minds to take free damage.
Exactly. Now they have to recall. They have to deal with their waves. This gives an opportunity for Paradise to group up or consider continuing on his side lane escapades.
We'll have the teleport advantage very soon as well.
Yeah, just generally an unusual move there from Tainted Minds. It felt desperate, but because there was no Baron, there was no big purple worm that is a lot easier to take down. They have to give it a go, honestly, and giving it a go was desperate already. This is why, because AV can just straight up do it.
Well, they're just calling for them to come out here as well as the Miasma's down, but Chenny Boy doesn't want to move that way. He wants to move back to the dragon. There's the shield. The big dragon once again going to disengage. Praedith going back to base. We'll see whether he can complete any important items here earlier.
They should be pushing Tainted Minds around the map right now, AV. They need to have Paradise on the top side, working towards that, which is the opportunity they need to actually go for the Elder Dragon. The likely strategy for the next minute or so, given that Praedith doesn't have his teleport, respectively.
Yeah.
Well, but now we get aggressive. Up there.
Seems like both of these teams just want to fight, giving them any opportunity as Omni is going to get stunned up. This looks pretty familiar right now as Triple picks up the kill on the Snake. AV set that one up pretty well, but Omni, of course, on his own a little bit.
Yeah, at it again, honestly, with being in a situation where he's just going to die to the pick that's available from the Jhin composition.
Chelby.
They need to kill him, otherwise they can't really win a fight.
Immediately flash out of the way. Nice stun comes in from Chenny onto Zahi. Chelby's aggression not going to be capitalized on this time from Tainted Minds.
Yes, too tanky and now stuck between a rock and a hard place. Middle lane's being pushed and top lane simultaneously, and they're all dying at once.
Yeah, both of those turrets do fall down as Jakey's health bar melts. Loss is going to be able to pick that one up. You can see the Fiora now battling onto Praedith. Nice equilibrium strike, doesn't get the stun as Paradise does want this one, but he's not going to be able to get it. It's a 1v1 as Praedith picks it up.
It's still a really unfortunate situation on the map at the moment with 50 seconds on Paradise. They could try and do something, and they do have the ability to do so given how big Lost is. His damage is through the roof.
This is a double flame horizon on different sides of the map as well. This is really cool.
Yeah.
Resource allocation, definitely a conversation you got to have as Zahi. You know, find himself a Chelby with the help of Praedith. Nice gravity field there as well though, but triple just saves his jungler. Chelby's just...
he's too tanky. All they really need to do here, AV, is hold the fort, but Tainted Mind's trying to force
Omni.
It.
One more time. Curtain Call flies through another Chaos Storm. Just wanders around Tainted Minds, who are taking so much damage.
They can't do it.
And the reset comes down as well. Another Deadly Flourish as Chanty Boy just searching for another stun.
They just poke it too long of a range. The Victor's ultimate, all that really needs to come down with the Jhin W, and they just want the Prey Seekers to try and set this all up, or the Karma Q to set it all up with it. Omni has consistently been caught out of position through these spells. And AV, they hold down, given that they had no top laner available. And now that he is back, he still has his teleport, and he can consider staying on the top side of the map with the open inhibitor present.
It's just one of these things where your AD carry has a whole host of utility. Chenny Boy, doesn't matter that he's 2-4-3. He's able to still set things up exactly right, and we're seeing exactly why that's the case.
Yeah, if the meta actually goes towards facilitative AD carries and carry top laners, it makes sense that they're making this work through the mid game, the strength that that does provide.
I have a sad story for Tainted Minds fans. It's the fact that Paradise now has 6 items. That is a Guardian Angel completed. He is gigantic. Lost throws down a culling. Triple takes the whole lot, gets the shutdown. Jesus.
Lost comes up pretty big here. The Baron's actually up in a second as well. They should actually look towards that. Instead, it feels like they want a siege.
Well, I don't know why Paradise is going back here, as Jake takes a bit of poke, because that's too open in here.
He needs to defend. He actually has to help defend if this four-man unit doesn't go towards the Baron. They hard push down. They get Fiora here. They can immediately either rotate to it, or they can just try and seize this one up and get a big fight.
Well, this inhibitor turret is going to fall down. Tainted Minds is grouping up as 5, understanding that they have 25 seconds to play with. This inhibitor falls. Now AV looking for a potential fight. Rosie stopping in his tracks. Miasma's there to stop anyone from dashing over the front door.
Yeah, now straight to that Baron. Minions actually heavily pushing in the top lane. Paradise with his teleport available could actually make a play. Depending on what happens at this Baron, it feels like the game's result is actually going to come out of this.
Oh, Scrying Orbs there. The Baron is likely to fall down as the Curtain Call flies through. Omni takes the first bullet as Chelby gets in a little bit late, but the Grand Challenge in a pretty good position. Solar Flare actually knocked away from with the Explosive Cast. Not exactly a great move, but Praedith is massive. Chelby down to his Guardian Angel. Chenny Boy's going to get destroyed, and Tainted Minds all grouped up together. Get rid of 2 members of this team. Actually, 1. Paradise is eventually going to fall down as Lost picks up the kill. Tainted Minds, can they actually come forward, follow some super minions in and take down this game?
They're playing this one a little bit more patient. With Praedith maybe needing to go back, unfortunately for him again, no teleport. So it looks like they just want to do this. They've got the Baron buff, they've got the super minions barreling down with it. And you would expect this game could be attempted at closed out. That was not English.
Yeah, but Triple does have the Chaos Storm. Not going to do a whole lot to these Baroned up minions. Oh, there it is. Praedith actually flashes over the top. Exhaust is down on the Aurelia. They get rid of him, but look at the Nexus turrets. Lost is just ripping them apart. Knockup comes out from Chelby, but Lost wants one thing right now, and it's to die to the turret after almost taking it down. Deadly Flourish is there, but Tainted Minds, they still have enough in order to try and take this one down.
Do
they? Oh my god, Chenny with the double. Will he get the triple? Body Slam gets Zahi out of the way of one, but not that one. Knockup comes in, the final crit comes down as well.
Fiora's teleporting.
A teleport from Paradise. Zahi's gonna die.
That's gonna be a game.
That is going to be it. That's the ace, and AV just send up a really big lady with a stick, and she'll smack down the house of Tainted Minds.
Tainted Minds, instead of going for the Elder Dragon, instead of playing it slow, they take the big risk. And I have nothing more to say besides what a disaster for Tainted Minds. They had the tools to potentially win that game and actually turned the snowball back around into their favor. But it's not going to be enough, apparently, as Paradise just respawns after dying and ends the game.
Yep, Praedith is now up. There are three members here. The Nexus is going to fall in Avon in a game that we weren't necessarily expecting. Able to pick up the victory in game number one against Tainted Minds.
Yeah, now Tainted Minds had an early lead, but they lost it all in the mid game. They found it in the late game and then lost it all again.
Yeah, just a bit of a topsy-turvy situation. So we're going to throw it back to the desk to try and wade through what was that game.
Oh, thanks, guys. What just happened? Like, that was a disaster for Tainted Minds, right? The game was kind of even, and then it just
exploded. Like, yeah. It was just even for a very long time, and nothing kind of happened, and then it just went bam, and then like suddenly like
yeah.
Is that is it because it was a greedy play? Is that what happened? They get too confident. They then decide, look, we're just going to finish this now, right? And they get overconfident.
I don't think it's greed. I think it's more like indecisive. Like, yeah, they won the fight,
yep,
and then the TM just like run to dragon, and yeah, then they're like, oh, no, let's go mid. And then, yeah, it's like those crucial like 10 seconds, 5 seconds even, just like running like all the way to dragon would have been lost just whacking the Nexus turrets and actually ending the game.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, legitimately, they actually could have ended that game. They actually legitimately, there were so many options they could do. Yeah, go to Elder Dragon, go to like actually the Nexus. But they were legit, just 10 seconds of them just like walking in
even,
a circle.
Even when they actually got to the Nexus, it was like half of them wanted to fight and then lost was just sitting there whacking the turret. It's like in the game and nobody saw you.
Well, let's take a look at that replay right now. This is the team fight that almost ended the game.
Yeah. So
it's like Zahi and Praedith just like dashed in for the kill, right?
Yeah exactly.
Yeah, so Lost was hitting the turret.
Yeah, just Lost was just hitting the turret. Like, they were committing to the fight halfway through. Like, Rosie went in, but at the same, now he goes. Let's see. Lost gets disintegrated by the turret itself because he was just under, like, whacking at him. So there was, you can just tell that probably the comms were just not clear. Possibly. Maybe that's what happened. But the entire game was just kind of a mess because I think Tainted Minds, you can even just, like, yeah. So Tainted Minds, from the very beginning, they had a lead. They actually put Chaney Boy so far ahead, yeah, because of that cheese play, you know, wait in the bush, wait for him to come out, and we'll just like Gragas body slam flash. They had such a clean way, a path of victory, and then Gragas started to path towards top side with, yeah, him, like help Irelia out.
So with that kind of indecision, when teams are deciding, do we go back to Dragon? Do we try and finish the game now? What's going on in the comms at that moment? Are people not hearing each other, or are people arguing? What's going on?
It's not even arguing. I think just everybody, like, that's a really high-pressure situation, right? Mm. Like, you're about to end the game. Like, this is a really important series for them. And then I think everybody is just talking. Like, some of them are like, Dragon, Dragon, Dragon! And the other guys are like, no, end! We can end! And so, like, they get midway to, like, Dragon, and then some of them, like, or, like, the overpowering call is to end the game.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so, like, they just waste those, like, crucial time. Like,
yeah,
crucial time.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, pretty much going, like, that was essentially what happened. But even go back to the point about how, like, Tainted Minds were in a massive point of victory, right? They actually had, like, if Jhin is that far behind, there's never a reason for you to lose out. But they just kind of stalled out for such a long time.
Yeah, I think you touched on Zahi going top lane. I think the game kind of played out like how we expected it to, where AV's top side got ahead and then TM's bot side got ahead. But I think Rosie on Leona, like that is a champion you can dive with. That is a champion that literally just wants to dive you. So like Zahi gets their bot lane ahead, yeah, and then gives them a lead, and then he just leaves and goes to help Praedith in his like dire situation, where I think like you, at that point you just leave Praedith, like he's alone, like he's kind of just going to get roasted by the Fiora, but it's like it's okay because you're winning the other side of the map.
Exactly.
And it's like just keep pressuring that bot side, use the Leona to dive instead of going up to like play the safe way. Like if they just played that through the bot lane, they would have had a big advantage and been able to carve out more of a lead.
Well, let's take a break right now with Tainted Minds down 0-1 with AV, and we'll be back after this with game two of week 9, night 1 of the OPL.